The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "A good tree does not bear rotten fruit, nor does a rotten tree bear good fruit. For every tree is known by its own fruit. For people do not pick figs from thorn bushes, nor do they gather grapes from brambles. A good person out of the store of goodness in his heart produces good, but an evil person out of a store of evil produces evil. For from the fullness of the heart, the mouth speaks. Why do you call me Lord, Lord, but not do what I command? I will show you what someone is like who comes to me, listens to my words, and acts on them. That one is like a man building a house, who dug deeply and laid the foundation on rock. When the flood came, the river burst against that house, but could not shake it because it had been built well. But the one who listens and does not act is like a person who built a house on the ground without a foundation. When the river burst against it, it collapsed, and once it collapsed at once and was completely destroyed." My friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters. Sa wikang Filipino, mayroon tayong kasabihan, kung ano ang itinanim, siya ang aanihin. Have you heard that? Narinig niyo na po ba yon? Yung kasabihan na yon, di ba? Alam natin yon. Sa literal na pakahulugan, walang nagtanim ng binhi ng mangga at iba ang naging bunga. Tama po. Dapat ang bunga ay, hello, pag binhi ng mangga ang tinanim, ano ang bunga? Definitely, mangga rin. Kung ano ang tinanim, siya ang bunga. Katulad din sa buhay, kung ang inyong ipinakita sa kapwa o kung ano man ang inyong ipinakita sa inyong kapwa, yun din ang magiging pagkakakilala sa inyo ng kapwa. My dear brothers and sisters, this is similar to what our readings would want to show us, similar, that we are known by our fruit. Tayo ay nakikilala sa ating bunga. Like what Jesus is telling His disciples, a good tree does not bear rotten fruit. Definitely. Nor does a rotten tree bear a good fruit. For every tree is known by its own fruit. So likewise to a person, a good person out of the store of goodness in his heart produces good, but an evil person out of store of evil produces evil. Sinasabi, kung ano ang kinikimkim sa puso, siyang lumalabas. And this what makes our heart a seedbed. Sa Tagalog, punlaan. Kaya ang puso natin, nagiging punlaan. That whatever we put or keep in our hearts, it will surely grow. This is the reason why we need to always purify our hearts. Because whatever you put in it, it will definitely grow. As Jesus said, from the fullness of the heart, the mouth speaks. Kaya nahuhuli natin ang tao eh. Nalalaman natin ang kanilang laman ng puso sa lumalabas sa kanilang bibig. For a person with a harsh tongue has an angry heart. Do you agree? Kapag yung dila ang lumalabas, masasamang salita, mayroong galit na puso. A person with a negative tongue has a fearful heart. Yung nega, wala nang nakitang maganda, yung lagi may puna, because takot ang puso. A person with an overreactive tongue has an unsettled heart. A person with a boasting tongue has an insecure heart. A person with a bad tongue has an impure heart. And a person who has a critical tongue has a bitter heart. This is the reason why Saint Paul, before his conversion happened, said so many bad things against the followers of Jesus. Ang dami niyang nasabing masasama, ang dami niyang puna, ang dami niyang batikos sa mga Kristiyano, because he has an angry heart. Galit siya sa kanila. Galit dahil taliwas ito sa kanilang paniniwala. He does not believe in Jesus. That's why he had an angry heart. That was before. Before his conversion. Before he had encounter with Jesus. But after his encounter with Jesus, matapos magpakilala si Jesus sa kanya, nagbago ang kanyang puso. He had a change of heart, which is conversion. If you look at the meaning of conversion, it means a change of heart. Kaya nga pag nagbabago, hindi lang binabago ang ginagawa, hindi lang binabago ang sinasabi, binabago ang puso. Dahil pag nagbago ang puso, mababago ang lumalabas sa bibig, mababago ang ginagawa. A change of heart. Now, after the conversion of Saint Paul, everything that comes out of his mouth is from his faithful heart. That is why he became a faithful follower of Christ. My dear brothers and sisters, take good care of your heart. Remember, it is a seedbed that whatever you keep in it will surely grow. Amen.